My name is Josh Moore, so I'm in part of our Cloud Analytics Product Management Group here at NetApp. We're talking a little bit today about Cloud Insights, which is how we can really monitor our stack. So a lot of the messaging around the booth is three clicks to the cloud. What happens after those three clicks? And that's where Cloud Insights comes in, to monitor and optimize your environment not only for performance, but for cost as well. And you may be pleased to know that this is my one and only slide, so we're going live demo today. And the reason for that is I find people pay more attention when it could turn into a train wreck at any moment. So don't go anywhere. Applications these days are comprised of so many different components, so many different technologies and platforms and services, that it can be really difficult to manage these. So, I mean, in the booth today, we've got NetApp Kubernetes Service, we've got Cloud Volume Service, and in addition, in the Cloud Data Services portfolio in NetApp, now, we've got another dozen products and services that are part of our cloud services. That's in addition to on-prem, hyper-converged, and storage and everything like that. And we're one vendor. And you could potentially have, you know, 20 different technologies from one vendor. In your environments, you've probably got 20 different vendors and 20 different technologies from each of those vendors. And when it comes to monitoring and managing that environment, you know, we've got different KPIs for different applications. We've got different metrics that we need to keep hold of. We've got potentially different cost drivers in all those different applications. It becomes really difficult to really get a view of. Now, you know, you may be an application owner and you think, well, I know what my application looks like, right? I don't need some tool to tell me what that looks like. But actually, there's other people in your environment that could really benefit from having that view of your environment, your application, and that context with what's going on in the rest of the environment. Similarly, from a management oversight point of view, it doesn't help to have lots of different bubbles that we can't see into. I mean, we can trust our application owners to tell us how it's performing, but when it comes to cost ownership and things like that across lots of these different bubbles, it's important to have a context and a view of all of these bubbles that a non-expert can actually consume. And this is really where Cloud Insights comes into it. So what Cloud Insights is a service from NetApp where you can monitor and optimize your applications, platforms, and technologies across multiple public clouds and across private clouds, and across applications that probably span all three of those. And that is a full stack monitoring tool. So what I mean by full stack is we've got over 100 different collectors that you can deploy in your environment, whether it's, you know, right at the top of the stack for really important user experience KPIs like response times, or bottom of the stack in terms like storage utilization and things like that. So we can get that view from the top to the bottom. So we can see everything in context of everything else. We can visualize that in a series of dashboards, so you can consume only the metrics you want to consume and how you want to consume them. Easy to use out of the box or create your own. You can define smart alerts, so conditional alerting and smart alerts, so you can reduce noise from that, because of course every different component in your application has a variety of KPIs and they're all shouting when something happens. So when something goes wrong, you could potentially have 1,000 different alerts that are all caused by one little incident. So we want to be able to filter out that noise to get to the source of the problem ASAP, so we can reduce that mean time to resolution. Maybe you just want to sit back and let machine learning do its thing. So with Cloud Insights, what if you can look at all of these different metrics and understand what normal is and highlight it when something looks a little bit unusual? So maybe you can go in and fix that problem before it actually causes an impact to end users. And then, of course, with all these metrics in one place, we can start attaching a cost to that through a very rich metadata model to track where we're not only overutilizing resources, but underutilizing resources. Where have I provisioned a big virtual machine somewhere that just doesn't need that level of resource assigned to it? So now we'll dip into the tool itself. So what we can see here is the Cloud Insights interface. And I was talking about full stack monitoring earlier. Well, what do I mean by that? This is an example of what I mean by that. So what we see here is a dashboard for a web application. So this is in our lab environment. Depending on, you know, what your environment looks like, this might look different. These are all the important KPIs we have in our environment. So right here at the top, we can see user experience KPIs. So these are the response times of the application itself. These are the most important KPIs to determine how this application is performing. But if we see something wrong here, it doesn't necessarily tell us where the problem is. We need to figure out that. This is where we can scroll down through the stack to identify what's happening in this stack. Where is my problem? Where do I need to troubleshoot? So I might want to look at my load balancer response times. Maybe if I'm the application owner, there's various metrics here that might be important to me. Now, if I see something that interests me here, For instance, if I'm the MySQL admin, I can go into this, I can troubleshoot the problem and fix it. But if I don't see my problem here, I can go further down the stack again. Look at my top latency from on-prem VMs. Look at my top latency for cloud-based VMs. Look at how my K8s are scaling. Look at capacity utilization. And ultimately, these are all kind of very high-level metrics in one place, but it lets us determine where the problem is in our environment. So one of the first steps of reducing mean time to resolution is reducing MTTI. Does anyone want to have a guess at what I mean by MTTI? So mean time to innocence. This is how long it takes to identify this is where the problem is in my stack. Everyone else that doesn't need to troubleshoot that, go back to your day jobs, because I know where that problem is, I know what I need to do to fix it. So for instance, if I see something here that I want to troubleshoot further, so out of my exceptions and violations, maybe I want to have a look at this server. I can get a very clear view of what's going on in terms of performance, all of my vital statistics, a view of the topology there, where it sits in my environment, what it's attached to. I can see that it's in a violation state here. So this pink area is where I've got a problem. But most importantly, what I can see is Cloud Insights has automatically ingested all the relationships in this environment, so it's built this virtual topology of what my application looks like that. And by doing that, I can correlate metrics from one application or one asset in my environment to another, and can pick out greedy and degraded work sources. So what Cloud Insights is telling me here, that I have a virtual machine that has a problem. It has a problem during this time window, and what we've detected is there is a high level of correlation to another greedy virtual machine over here. So it's telling me this is where I need to go to fix this problem. So we talked in the first instance about optimizing performance and cost. So let's look at a little bit at the second half of that equation. So the first step of saving cost is first identifying what we're spending and how we're spending it. So this is a high-level dashboard. It's looking at our GCE environment. So we're spending $29,000 a month, and these are all the instance types where we're spending it. But what I want to know is, where am I spending on an instance type that is in excess of what I need? So this number here is where Cloud Insights has looked at that and said, you know what? You've provisioned virtual machines over here that are just too big for what you need them for. And if you did something about that, you could potentially save $10,000 a month. And this is where our spend to utilization ratio is here. So what I'm looking for is these dots down in this bottom right corner there where I'm spending a lot of money on a resource and not really using it very well. So if I want to dig more into this is a high level dashboard, I can look a bit deeper as well. So on a per instance basis, where have I got, you know, instances that are using less, what are my top 10 using less than, you know, a predefined threshold of resources? What are my top utilization levels in storage? Where are my powered off virtual machines? Where have I got virtual machines that have storage attached that have been powered off that aren't being used? So I can go and pick out which resources I need to go and identify for reclamation. But of course, that's only half of cost saving because I need to find out what's running on these. You know, can I just blast this away or do I need to save this? So this is why Cloud Insights has a very rich metadata model. So I can start to attribute this utilization and this cost to different business groups. So how is marketing using these resources? How is HR and sales using these resources? I can even go a step further. So we're all familiar with chargeback and showback. What I like to talk about is shameback. So where have I got users that are consuming a high level of cloud resources that just don't need it? We find that very often the people that are consuming the resources in the cloud don't necessarily have access to that bill. And you know, you get a bill from Google at the end of the month, and it's a huge spreadsheet and takes a degree to just decipher it. What we can start to do in Cloud Insights is attribute that spend to individual users, highlight where there's been something provisioned that's in excess of what required. And you know, it may not be just out of not caring. It could be a case of, you know, someone misunderstanding the requirements or a workload no longer being required and being decommissioned. But what's important is that we can identify that so we can go and reclaim those resources and reduce that cost. Of course, the cloud is a bottomless pit of resources, but we don't necessarily have a bottomless budget. So by now you're probably thinking, this is great. How do I see this in my own environment? Yes? Yes? Yeah, great. So with Cloud Insights, we do offer a 14-day free trial. So it's all well and good to see, you know, to see dashboards in our lab environments and things like that. But what you want to see is, where can I save money in my own environment? Where can I start tracking my KPIs and applications in my own environment as well? So if you go to cloud.netapp.com, navigate to the Cloud Insights product page. You can click here and register for a free trial. You get 14 days. It's really quick and easy to get up and running. It takes about, you know, half an hour, if that, to get it deployed in your environment, get it collecting metrics, and then you can start picking dashboards pre-built out of the gallery, start to build your own dashboards to really see the metrics that you want to see in the way you want to see them, and really just get going and start saving cost and start optimizing your metrics. And thanks for listening.